everyone. Welcome back. Today in this video, we are going to learn about a magical substance, and that is air. We all like the climate of spring, isn't it? Similarly, how relaxing is the cold breeze of air on a hot summer day? What is this air? Can you see it? No, but yes, you can feel it. Is air only to feel? Or is there any other importance of air as well? Yes, there are many gases in the air which are necessary for all living beings, like oxygen, which is necessary for respiration of living beings, and it is also necessary for combustion, and carbon dioxide. Trees and plants make their own food with the help of carbon dioxide, and marine animals also absorb the carbon dioxide dissolved in water to make their own shells. This air covers the earth in something like this, which is called atmosphere. Do you know how important the atmosphere is to the earth? It helps in controlling the climate. But how does it happen? Let's see. You know that air is a bad conductor of heat. So, during the daytime, due to the heat coming from the sun, the atmosphere does not allow the temperature to rise, and at night, it prevents the heat from going outside the atmosphere into the space, and in this way, the atmosphere maintains the temperature on the earth. Friends, have you ever wondered how cold air flows or thunderstorms come? In order to understand, let us perform an experiment. Take two beakers A and B. Add water to beaker A and sand to beaker B. And after that, insert thermometer to both the beakers. Now, keep the beakers under sunlight. What do you observe? The temperature in both of the beakers starts rising. Is temperature in both beakers the same? No. B's temperature is higher than A. This means sand is heated quickly than water. But what if these beakers are kept in the room? Let's see. Do you see the same temperature in the thermometer now? Absolutely correct. The temperature of beaker B is lower, which means sand cools faster than water. So friends, are you able to understand something? Sand heats and cools down faster than water. The same happens in the coastal region. In the coastal region, during the daytime, the land gets heated faster than the sea. That is why the air above the land gets heated up, and the hot air starts rising up, and the cold air over the sea starts moving towards the land. The same happens at night. The land cools faster than the sea water, and the warm air above the sea rises up. The cold air above the land starts moving towards the sea. So friends, did you understand how the wind blows? Well, it can be said, wind blows due to uneven heating. Friends, do you know rain also occurs due to wind? But how? Let's see now. Due to sunlight, the surface of water bodies gets heated and gets converted into water vapor. This process is called evaporation. But how does this water vapor go into the sky? Well, due to sunlight, during the day, the air also gets heated up and it rises up. While rising, it gets mixed with the water vapor and finally goes into the sky. Up in the sky, temperature is low, due to which the water vapor starts to cool to form water droplets. These small droplets mix with dust particles and other suspended particles, combine to form clouds. And this process is called condensation. Due to continuous condensation, these clouds become heavy and they fall down in the form of water droplets, which we call as rain. This process is called precipitation. Sometimes, due to low temperature, precipitation also occurs in the form of snow or hail. Well, there is no doubt, air is very important for us. But what will happen if it gets polluted? There are so many problems due to air pollution, like heart attack, cancer, lung disease, global warming, etc. But do you have any idea how it's getting polluted? The main causes of air pollution are smoke released from cars and factories and burning of fuels. Due to all these, harmful gases like sulfur dioxide, carbon monoxide are getting into the air and polluting it. But can it be prevented? Yes, air pollution can be prevented. Let us see how. By reducing the use of fossil fuels, by using public transport, by planting more and more trees, and by using energy-saving appliances, we can prevent air pollution. So what did you learn in this video? Win, importance of air and air pollution. In the next video, we will study water and water pollution.